Jersey Sports Zone's coverage of Bergen Catholic is brought to you by Rothman Orthopedics. It's the last Saturday of the regular season. Teams across New Jersey looking to make one final impression before the playoffs. The same goes for the non-publics. Bergen Catholic and DePaul looking to close their seasons on a high note. It's DePaul driving first. The connection between Andrew Butler and Teddy Affle has been stellar this season. Here, they pick up 11 yards and a first down. DePaul's drive stalls, and they decide to kick, so it seems. Hold on, though. We've got a fake. Andrew Butler hits Gibson Nichols open in the end zone. Head coach John McKenna not holding back in this one. DePaul leads 7-0. And here comes Bergen Catholic with an answer. Next drive for BC. Andrew Bowl rips one and finds Joe Anello for six. It's a 9-yard strike, and we've got a 7-7 ball game after one. DePaul's MO Saturday was the big play. Butler again with a strike. This time, Marshawn Ferguson open on the slant, and he's got speed. Ferguson goes 54 yards, taking it down to the Bergen Catholic 11. Butler really settling in nice. Rolling out, it's Damir White wide open in the flat for six. DePaul jumps in front of the Crusaders, making it 14-7 early second quarter. It's a back-and-forth game now. Steve Angeli in at QB. On third and long, he finds Shane Prevo climbing the ladder. That's a 32-yard pickup. The reason Bergen Catholic has been so successful is their team depth. Andrew Ball kicks it out to LaRue Linder. And look at this effort. A stiff arm and a truck stick for Linder as he gets into the zone. We're going tit for tat here. It's 14-14 in the second. DePaul retakes the lead a few minutes later. Matt Wilderson from 35 yards out, it's good. DePaul now up 17-14, 3:24 left in the half. Now this is where things get wild. Angeli pressured by the Spartan defense, hit by Quayer Price, and it's loose. Kamar Howard scoops it up, and Howard takes it to the crib. What a momentum swing here for DePaul. 10 straight points in a matter of moments. The Spartans now leading 24-14. This DePaul defense is now rolling on all cylinders. A Corey Lide sees it the whole way through and comes up with the INT. Lide working the rock downfield, finding plenty of running room here, and he's going to pick up some major yardage after the pick. Gets down to the BC 35, under 2 minutes left in the half. And the drive is finished off on this 1-yard quarterback sneak from Andrew Butler, who crosses the plane. What a first half effort here from DePaul Catholic. They lead Bergen Catholic 31-14 at the break. Third quarter, Bergen chipping away at the lead, but the field goal's blocked. Seemingly another stop by DePaul. But hold on though, this would get changed. Roughing the center is called. Bergen Catholic gets a fresh set of downs. And they'll gladly take the second chance. Ryan Butler gets the call from 3 yards away. There's no stopping him. At the end of three quarters, it's DePaul 31, Bergen Catholic 21. Fourth quarter now, Bergen Catholic looking to complete the comeback. Steve Angeli flashing great touch on a deep ball. Amar Gist picks up 36 yards and a huge first down for the Crusaders. And again, BC leans on their stud sophomore back, Ryan Butler. Tons of room. He's like a runaway freight train. 21 yards for Butler. BC makes it a 3-point game. It's 31-28. 6 minutes left in the fourth. BC now back on offense. 2 minutes left from their own 33. Angeli with time looking to get this comeback underway. But Charles Finley breaks through. Eddie Birrell's in there to finish it off. A huge stop by the Spartans defense late. It comes down to this play. Fourth and long from the 42. Angeli with time. Looking deep. And he overthrows his man. DePaul Catholic goes into victory formation with 102 seconds left in the game. And they score a major upset win over Bergen Catholic. DePaul scored all of their 31 points in the first half. Their defense came through when it mattered in a 31-28 win. Bergen outgained DePaul 373-243, but lost their turnover battle and committed six more penalties. Most certainly, it's DePaul Catholic's biggest win of the season, and they picked a great time to do it on the eve of the non-public playoff seeding committee, giving them plenty to think about.
We just got to take the confidence we've gained from this game. We got to continue to work hard at practice, just continue to practice as hard as we can, and really just use the confidence and use the momentum into the playoffs.
I'm very proud. Coach Mack, he expressed he didn't care about the score. He just wanted us to play really hard, and I feel like we did that.
Reporting from Oradell, I'm Jay Cook with JerseySportsZone.com.